Yeah, this guy's music fits my ears like a G glove. Well, okay, you don't put gloves on your ears, but just let me have the simile, okay? Get off my back. Greetings, one and all, and welcome back to Tom's Hit Parade. Coming at you with my first Now and Then of 2020. A little bit sooner than I expected, and also a different artist than I was expecting to ring in the feature in the new year with. For those of you who might be newcomers to my channel, who might not be familiar with, the concept Now and Then is my recurring feature in which I talk about two albums by the same artist, their newest release as well as one from their back catalog. And today I will be throwing the Now and Then spotlight on Philadelphia recording artist G Love. And for now, I'll be talking about his brand new album, The Juice. Yeah, vinyl record, not a CD. Told you I was going to be shaking things up in the new year, huh? Anyway, yes, I have been aware of the existence of G Love and Special Sauce, his backing band, since they started making albums a little over 25 years ago. I think 1994 was their first release, but I never bothered checking them out for a very simple reason. Until very recently, as those of you who've been watching my channel know, I just could not get into hip-hop until very recently, and I've been aware of enough to know that from the very beginning, G Love and Special Sauce had been incorporating a fair bit of hip-hop into their sound. Now, this is probably the third time in recent memory that this has happened, that I've been thinking about maybe finally checking out an artist I've been aware of and been curious about for a little while, and kind of been looking for an excuse to do so. And well, wouldn't you know it, back in, I think it was October or November, that I saw the first press release about this album, which revealed that G Love would be collaborating with, and here's a name that you've heard on my channel recently a couple of times, Keb Mo, on this new album. And then now, before I go any further, if you're not familiar with G Love, and this is actually a reason why I strategically chose G Love as a Now and Then subject, just because some, probably not most, but some of my audience probably does not know who G Love is and has never heard of him, considering his heyday was back in the mid-90s. The sound, basically, of G Love is, think two parts Philly soul and one part hip-hop, is basically what it is. So in that respect, he reminds me a little bit of Anderson .Paak, or at least Anderson .Paak's most recent album, Ventura. But the difference with G Love, though, is that from what I know about him, which I will admit is limited thus far, he has been injecting little bits of other influences into his sound as well, ranging from everything from pop to jazz, and probably a few other things that I'm not aware of yet. But as you might expect, since Keb Mo is a major influence on this album, he's produced the album and appears on several of its tracks, you would expect that there is a generous dollop of blues and country in here, which there is. When I think about it, this album pretty much came along at a perfect time for me, because, you know, considering that as little as a couple of years ago, I really didn't care at all for hip-hop, blues, or country, and this album pretty much has all three in fairly significant quantities. Now, lyrically speaking, the overall vibe on this album is one of positivity, peace, love, happiness, universal brotherhood, community brotherhood, that kind of thing. The first single, for example, Go Crazy, is it, which features Keb Mo on backing vocals and on guitar. That's pretty representative of what this album has to offer. It's got a wonderful groove to it, for one thing, and also a great lyrical hook, I'm Gonna Lose My Mind If I Don't Go Crazy. So it's, you know, just about, you know, letting loose and having fun, not letting life get you down, is basically the message of that song and the album overall, pretty much. The opening track, which is the title track, The Juice, just to warn you, if this is the first G Love song that you listen to, don't let the lyrical delivery in that song turn you off. He does it this way on purpose, and it's very different from pretty much all the other songs by G Love that I've heard. He does the rap delivery, it's mostly done rapping rather than singing. He does it in a very old school delivery, reminds me of, you know, the old school early days of hip hop. Very lyrically light verses and very even pacing. So yeah, don't let that scare you off of G Love in general. One of the standout songs on side A of this album is called Shake Your Hair, and the lyrical structure, I guess you'd say, of the song's verses, it's like a stream of consciousness list of pop culture items and stuff. In that respect, it reminds me of Billy Joel's We Didn't Start the Fire, but that's where the similarities end. I mean, this is much more of a rootsy sounding song, for one thing. And also, it's not so much an existential type of song as We Didn't Start the Fire tends to be. This is just a song about, you know, living in the moment, live life to the fullest, you know, every moment you can. Don't get caught up in the craziness and the crap, you know, enjoy life is basically what it is. Another great, great song on here on side A is called Fix Your Face. And it's one of a couple of old school blues type of songs on here. And don't let the title fool you. It's not about, fixing your face in the old school sense of it, you know, saying like a woman needs to put makeup on her face or anything to make herself look beautiful. It's not about that. I won't give it away. Just listen to the song and you'll see what I mean. It's just a great song with a great sentiment. And yeah, it's just one of the reasons that I'm starting to appreciate more and more old school blues. Another song that actually starts off side B on here is called She's the Rock, and that's just a great syncopated rootsy love song with some great lyrics that I wouldn't be surprised if this song shows up when springtime rolls around in one of those hopefully not too cheesy romantic comedy movies. It's going to be one of those songs I think is going to gain a little bit more of a profile come springtime when romance is in the air. Another good song on side B is actually the song right after that, Diggin' Roots. It's another standout. It's just got a great mid-tempo beat to it and an engaging chorus like most of the songs on this album. And Birmingham is another one it's probably a close second for my favorite track on side B after She's the Rock. It's just a fantastic, rousing stomper, and it's got not only Keb Mo in it, but it also has Robert Randolph in a featured spot. He's a soul artist that I've just gotten to recently. Now, there are really only about two tracks on here that just didn't do much for me. Soul BQ, which is the second track on side A, as well as the last track, not counting a little reprise at the end of the album, Drinking Wine, that's on side B. Those two songs, they just kind of felt like filler tracks to me. Just haven't been able to get into them, at least not yet. They might still grow on me. But if those are the worst that this album has to offer, honestly, you could do a whole lot worse than to check out this album, really. It's just, as I said, as you can tell, I can't say enough good things about it. It's just a great album, a great way to kick off 2020, honestly. So check out The Juice by G-Love. But that was now, and this is then. Yeah, it's that easy. G-Love and Special Sauce's third album from 1997. Now, this almost wasn't a Now and Then video, because The Juice was the first G-Love album that I ever bought, and I almost just decided to review it. I liked it so much, I almost decided to review it on its own in a video. But as luck would have it, I found this, one of his previous albums, in the $2.50 section at a local record store. So I decided to pick it up, and turns out I really enjoyed it almost as much as The Juice, and that's basically sent me down the rabbit hole of G-Love, and I've actually got three more of his CDs on the way, even. But whereas The Juice has a generous helping of blues and country to it, and Americana, thanks to Keb Mo, Yeah, It's That Easy is not only closer to G-Love's hip-hop-inflected beginnings, it's got more hip-hop in it than The Juice has, but the instrumentation is packed with jazz influences of all things. So these are two very, very different albums, but honestly, G-Love pulls them both off wonderfully. I mean, it really shows his versatility as an artist, and in a way his growth, based on what I've heard so far. Now, one of the most meaningful songs on this album is called Slipped Away, the Ballad of Loretha Verd, and it was written in memory of the first female Philadelphia police officer ever shot and killed in the line of duty. So that prompted me to look up the story on Wikipedia, look up Loretha Verd, and it's just a fascinating story, and I kind of love it when I unexpectedly learn things just by listening to music. I mean, this has just opened up my eyes to a small chapter in history, but a chapter in history nonetheless that I never knew about. And another song on here with socially conscious lyrics is 200 Years, and that uses the birth year of his sister, and I'm not sure if he's talking his actual sister or a colloquial sister, of 1976, that is the bicentennial year of the United States, as a springboard for talking about our country and its somewhat dubious legacy in various aspects. So that's another very, very interesting song, and it shows his gift for lyrics of, for weighty lyrics, lyrics with meaning. And there are also plenty of just-for-fun songs as well. I-76, which doesn't do much for me, but only because it's basically a salute to the Philadelphia 76ers, the basketball team, as well as to the city at large. Now, probably my favorite song on this album is called Take You There. It's got just an amazingly smooth flow to the song, just a gorgeous instrumental to it. It's got a groove to it that reminds me of the Latin jazz albums of the 1950s. Which might not be a valid frame of reference for some of my audience. You might never have heard that kind of stuff. But trust me, it's got to be heard to be appreciated. It's just a great, great song. And it has great vocal harmony arrangements, too, on it. And another great song on here is Pull the Wool, which is, it's another example of just a great instrumental groove. And at 9 minutes long, the song just really has a lot of, plenty of time to just get into itself in the best way possible. So yeah, it's just a great album from front to back. And as good as the vocals are on this album, I mean, G-Love's rap delivery is just excellent on here. This is a good album to get a good example of G-Love's typical rap delivery, as opposed to the opening song on the Juice, as I was talking about. The lyrics are great, and the singing is just what it should be. You know, it should be a little bit rough. This is not the kind of music that calls for the spot on, pitch perfect, clear pop singing. You know, it's got a little bit of a rough edge to it. It's just perfect. So yeah, as great as the vocal angle on this album is, I absolutely love the instrumentals on this album. I would love to hear an instrumental version of this album. It's just fantastic. Most of the arrangements on here are the small jazz combo kind of a feel, but a handful of the songs have a bit more of a funk or soul feel to them. There's a song on here called You Shall See, and another example of the more funky soul stuff is, at a slower pace, is the song Willow Tree. It's just, you know, and these remind me of the grooves on some of Beck's early songs. So yeah, this album has, in some aspects, a bit of an early Beck vibe to it. So yeah, I mean, just, this is an album, I'm kind of like The Juice, but in some aspects even more so than The Juice. You gotta check out this album. Check out G-Love's discography, as I am just about to check out more of his discography here. Now, I wanted to make a couple of observations about G-Love before I render my verdict, as I like to do at the end of these videos, to tell you which album I prefer more. A couple things about G-Love that I noticed that tend to set him apart from other hip-hop or hip-hop-adjacent artists. First of all, you will, from time to time, you will hear harmonica. And yes, G-Love plays the harmonica, which is, ironically, you hear it more on his earlier stuff than you hear it on The Juice. And, you know, when you think about it, harmonica is kind of more a fixture of roots and country and Americana and blues music than it is soul music. I guess that's arguable, but anyway. But yeah, G-Love is pretty proficient on the harmonica, as he is proficient at just about everything else he does, from what I've heard so far. So yeah, that's kind of a cool thing, and that, you know, in a way that reflects his love of, you know, his mutual love of blues music as much as soul music over the years. So, and yeah, that's great. That's one thing that sets him apart, as I said. And also, from listening to what I've heard of his discography so far, which, as I said, is limited, he uses virtually no sampling. Actually, I think on both of these albums, he doesn't do any sampling at all on here, which is very, very different from a lot of hip-hop artists out there. They like to sample other, you know, older pre-existing songs. And yeah, G-Love and his band do all the arrangements, the instrumental arrangements themselves, which really sets them apart and gives them extra points in my book. So anyway, now, as to which album I would recommend more, honestly, it depends on what mood you're in, really. If you're more in the mood for a roots Americana blues country type of thing, check out The Juice. Or, you know, if you ask me, check it out even if you're not in the mood for that stuff. Honestly, I love this album, what can I say? But if you're in the mood more for hip-hop soul kind of stuff, check out his earlier stuff, particularly Yeah, It's That Easy. So yeah, honestly, I'm really torn, and I'm eager. I literally cannot wait. I think they're in the mail now. Well, no, I ordered them yesterday, so they won't be in the mail until Monday. Three more of his CDs are on their way to me, because I cannot wait to hear more of G-Love and Special Sauce. Yes, it's his earlier albums that I've ordered. So yeah, a fantastic artist that I cannot recommend enough. And oh, and a couple things before I close out this video that I noticed. G-Love is kind of representing a turning point in my listening. Might sound a little weird, but one thing that I noticed, I first noticed it while listening to G-Love here in preparation for this video, is that it's the first time that I've not really found myself paying attention to when an artist is singing versus when they are rapping. Honestly, you know, up until now, even with Anderson .Paak last year, I was, you know, always conscious of when he was singing in a song and when he was rapping, and, you know, the transitions between the two. But in this one, I didn't notice, primarily because he is so good at both that I didn't care whether he was rapping or singing. And it's just, I guess that kind of means, it might not sound like a big deal to you, but it's a big deal to me, considering just a couple of short years ago, I pretty much stayed away from hip-hop like the plague, or like the coronavirus, I guess. It's just, you know, and it's just, I've really turned a corner, I think. I think you guys are witnessing a turning point in my music listening with this, with G-Love. My discovery of G-Love is just amazing. It's probably my first great discovery of 2020, of this decade. So yeah, if that's the way to start, that this decade is starting out, bring on the 2020s, honestly. This has just been a great, it's only 1 month over, and this year has been a great year for music for me already. So, folks, I hope you had fun with my look at G-Love Now and Then. And that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Suggestions, questions, constructive criticisms, lay them on me in the comment section below. Also, scroll down to the description for a link to my Twitter feed and links to my favorite fellow YouTubers who are all worth checking out. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and browse my past videos, and be sure to ring that notifications bell so you'll be the first to know each time I drop a new video. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time, and remember, life's too short to be a music snob.